Once again, hear a wonderful rendition of the national anthem from Miss Miranda Coffey.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the pale. gallantly streaming, and the rockets red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
All right, then, Archie.
Wonderful job. Thank you very much, Miranda Coffey, Ray Dedrick. Let's go racing with the the 7, and we are coming to green this time. It looks like Vineyard's going to tag the tail. Not sure what the problem is with the 4 of Mike Vineyard. All right, here we go. It's Smith and Welsh on the fire lines in turn to 4. 8 laps, everybody goes. And McLean is in the air. Now the first straightaway to fall. Oh, contact early on between Smith on the bottom. Welsh on the outside. Oh, Smith with Collins. 3 wide, briefly for the lead. Welsh through the middle. Crabtree on the bottom. Smith falls back to second. It's Crabtree riding in third. But it's Hunter Best. C. Smith going to have a challenge for second. It is Crabtree second at the line here on lap number 1. C. Smith having gambling issues as he goes to the top of 1 and 2. That's going to open the door. New third place man is Hunter Best. Here comes Daniel Baggerly. Baggerly goes to the bottom. Smith pushes top side. Baggerly to the bottom. They're door-to-door contact. Baggerly falls back. Smith takes over fourth. Somebody backs off the wall. I believe the 25 on Rodney Kikerd. Kikerd issues. Baggerly closing in on C. Smith down the back straightaway. Smith going to roll it easy in the 3. Pushes up the racetrack. Opens the door for Baggerly. He's on the round pedal. They'll make contact. Both back off the gas. Baggerly takes the spot. Opens the door for Kikerd. Kikerd goes by. Smoke out of the left front of that car. As he'll go to the bottom of Baggerly for fourth down the back straightaway. Baggerly on the top in 3. Kikerd to the bottom. Smoke showing out of the 25 car. Problems for him. He's showing heavy smoke underneath the wheel. Now, I believe he's got issues, big time issues on turn 1. Spraying for mosquitoes through turn 1 and 2. Smith opens the door for Robbie Moses. Oh, Moses goes around. Bottom of 2. Bottom of 2. All right, well, caution flag coming out here on lap number 4. Lap number 4, halfway. A lot of smoke out from underneath the 25 of Rodney Kikerd, and he is dropping oil on the racetrack, and there's now an oil fire underneath the machine at the 25 car to Greenville, Tennessee, who sat on the pole of the Lucas Oil Late Model Routines race last weekend at Tazewell. Just seven, everybody can see the ill-handling 3 car. Steve Smith with problems. And it's in his discretion. It's when they're on fire. If they haven't fired by the time they get to the fire line in turn 4, it'll be up to the race director and flag. The race director ran the tower on the receiver controls, telling these guys we're coming to green. And it's Rush with Crabtree, Best, 4 down, 4 to go. Green is in the air. Green flag. Back out. We'll see if anybody challenges. Moses to the bottom of Kelso. Baggerly to the top in 1. He'll dive bomb. Here comes Crabtree. Crabtree for the lead down the back straightaway. Crabtree wants it. Welshman has it. On the top is Welshman. Pushes up the racetrack. There's Crabtree. Contact. Crabtree leads down the first straightaway. Crabtree, Welshman. Here comes Best. Baggerly searching for some grip on the top. He almost had it, but had to back up. Down the back straightaway, they're trying to chase down the young Hunter Best. It's the 16-year-old Best, the 19-year-old Baggerly. They'll work out of 4. Russell takes over 4th. White flag in the air. David Crabtree sees it. Crabtree, no pressure as the white flag flies to him. It's Welshman, Best, Baggerly, Russell, Smith, Moses, and Kelso slowly down the back side. Looks like everybody's content and where they're riding out of 4. Here's a race tire. Heat race win. And starting 11th is a C5 of David Crabtree followed by Jason Welshman and Hunter Best through top 3. Baggerly coming home. Russell, then it was Smith at the line over Moses, Kelso, and Kikerd. So, with that being being said, ladies and gentlemen, here's your race car. He raced this sort of limits. And our 50 lap 5,000 men starting a lineup is car number C5. Put your hands together out of Maryville, Tennessee for David Crabtree. Jason Rushman finishing second after leading early, followed by Hunter Best to 007, then the 16 of
Bamberg, going green in the Lee Smith late models on the playlist, the 007 of Hunter Best. The 10 is Chris Wilson, the 89 Adam Miller, 15 is Jason Sotomayor, 005 is David Young Jr., 91 Chuck Laney, 148 Herb Gardner, the 92 is Junior Walker. Outside in the 10, that's Chris Wilson. He will take the lead going into turn number 3. Sneaking in behind in the 007, that's Hunter Best. In the 89, it's Adam Miller. Best picks off the lead and will lead. Lap number 1 as he now hauls off his racer in the turn number 2. And here comes the 89 of Adam Miller taking a look underneath the 10 of Chris Wilson. Meanwhile, in 4th is the 15 of Jameson Sotomayor. 5th is David Young Jr. Picking off second spot is the 89 of Adam Beeler. Sneaking away with the 3-car length lead is the 007 of Hunter Best. Man on the move is the 15 of Sotomayor. He'll now pick off third spot as the 10 of Wilson now shakes it down going into turn number 3 in fourth spot. Running high up the wall in the 89 is Adam Beeler bringing out caution number 1. Hunter Best, the 10 is Chris Wilson, 15 Jameson Sotomayor, 005 is David Young Jr., 91 Chuck Laney, 148 Herb Gardner, 92 is Junior Walker. Once again, Wilson in the 10 fades a little high, allowing the 15 of Sotomayor to sneak underneath in turn 3 to pick off second spot. Meanwhile, on the point, it's the 007 of Hunter Best. Pyraminis and Mini-Stock, we need both groups of the Pyraminis and Mini-Stockers in the starting group for your feature events. Pyraminis and Mini-Stockers. Battle for third in the 005, that's David Young Jr. Once again, the 10 of Wilson slips coming out of turn 2, allowing the 005 of David Young Jr. to grab alongside. Meanwhile, your leader is the 007 of Hunter Best, the 15 is Jameson Sotomayor. Now we have a battle up front. The 15 of Sotomayor gets up within 2 car lengths, but he slides just a little bit coming out of turn number 2. Still your leader in the 007 is Hunter Best, and stealing away with the third spot is the 005 of David Young Jr. Meanwhile, the 91 of Chuck Laney eyeballs the 10 of Wilson for fourth spot. For third spot between David Young Jr. and Chris Wilson, and also we have a battle for the lead up front. It's the 007 of Hunter Best, the 15 of Sotomayor. This time by will be 8. lap 2 remaining in the knee, spin the low model. Looks like the 007 of Hunter Best is going to have to wrestle with the lap traffic and the 15 of Sammeyer. Best has no trouble with the lap traffic, and then here comes Sammeyer taking the white flag. One way remaining for the 007 of Hunter Best. Sotomayor. Coming home third will be the 10 of Chris Wilson. Battle for fourth spot is going to go to the 91 of Chuck Laney. Finishing top five will be the 148 of Herb Gardner. Beautiful photos on MRN, as well as his website, giving the checkered flag to that Warrior chassis of Hunter Best. Hunter will go over and see his friends and fans in Tier Parking, and work his racer back over to the main grandstand and then to the Elliott's Tire Center victory lane. It's a big show. Randy Weaver is usually in the mix. We'll check it as we get in or get underway here for this 50-lap, 5,000-to-win main event.
Come on, Maryville, Tennessee, stand on your feet as they work out of turn number four. Here we go. Down the way to the U.S. fans. Make some noise down the front straightaway for the 2010 Southern All-Star. Great racing scene. Come on, let's hear you. Make some noise. Make some noise, Maryville, Tennessee. Out of the four, wide formation, your front row on the inside, your middle rows on the outside, down the front straightaway.
Quite a few of the drivers giving some hand signals about some oil spots on the racetrack, so we're definitely going to make this thing safe and get this thing underway and make it safe all at the same time. There's been a lot of oil dropped down on the racetrack, not only by the lower divisions, but a couple of cars in the Supers as well. Freddie Smith dropped some oil on the track very early on, and Rodney Kiker in the B-Main there.
Southern All-Star Racing Series.com, Southern All-Stars Racing Series. This time by, it is Weaver, it is Giffen, over Kerr, Weeks, and Krill, your first remotes. In the three and four, green flag is in the air. Weaver fires, shuts down the first remote. Giffen goes back to second. Weaver on the top of the 14. top, and he is very lucky that he didn't give a tying after our initial start. After we complete a lap, then we're going to take some double file restarts where the leader has to roll all by himself. The second place man chooses either the inside or outside line, and everybody else is subsequent to follow the opposite of what the driver in front of them did. So we are coming back to green this time by as the initial start here. Even and Griffin.
So during a caution, that second place man can make some decisions for the rest of the field, for that matter.
And he holds the call as to what the rest of the field does, but the leader gets to roll all by himself. That's after the initial restart. We're going with the initial start here. Out of four, the flag, green flag is in the air. Boy, we will charge the start. It's good for the takes a minute to put in. Back to turn one and see if we get from the 1-2 better off this time. Some jumping around. Three wide. Here comes Weeks on the bottom. Weeks splits the 2-0 of Ogle. And Weeks going to go back to 4-2.
And that's kind of scrubbed off some speed, but if he could get a smooth lap around there, he may be the faster car. He definitely closed the gap in a hurry on this 116 of Weaver, but Weaver always gets the jump at the drop of the green. We'll see how it checks out this time.
All right, we're coming to green this time by. They're firing out turn four. It's Weaver's decision once they're clearly in turn four, is what they're instructed. All right, Brad, here we go. Coming to four, number five, so green. Down the first straightaway, it just amazes me the start that Weaver's getting. Weaver's going to go to work on the outside. He'll try to pull alongside Kerr. Kerr edges ahead. And the top three, there's a throw in the turn three on the bottom.
Weaver choosing a high line. Kerr right in the middle of the racetrack. Weaver's seems to gain down the front stretch. Kyle always catches him in the corners, however.
Kyle working the top off of two, the battle for six between him and Jason Wilson. Kyle throws it in, Brad. He may be trying to set him up in turn one. Lee leads in the win. Scott Crowe having a heck of a battle. The battle for, let's say, seventh spot. It was all in four. Back to turn one. The battle for the champion.
Every time Kerr gets a jump, he hits a rut or loses his momentum. He's back about four car lengths now.
Riding the bottom. That's the top five. It's Reed, Kerr, Weeks, Payne, Griffin, and it's Wilson. He'll make the bad streak. These two drivers racing at Colorado Social with Tony South, Frankleton, Louisiana, Scott Cole, and look for Howard Curtis running with Hollis Wood.
Freddie Smith up in that mix now. He's got to the wrap up roof. Creel looked to the inside there for a moment. Now it's nose to tail down the back chute.
Doug Smith, a 45 car, he'll be a lap down shortly. He's going to come into the crosshairs and leave the river. From Tommy Kerr. Kerr stole a huge lead over 4 points. Mike Weeks, then it's David Bain. Bobby Giffen, top five, battle for six. Here comes Ronnie Lee. Ronnie Lee Hollingsworth is on fire in turn four.
He'll get by the tail jam. Jason Wilson, he's got a lot of laps. He's in sort of a backup ride, a borrowed ride, if you will. Now, as you mentioned, the 18 of Hollingsworth chasing down the next car. They're over in turn four.
Top of turn number four, and Doug Smith can run to a stop. Kerr is out. Caution is out. Doug Smith, top of turn four, and man, Kerr is closing in again. Kerr closing in a hurry, and is 18 going to be in fourth? Did he make the pass? No, he will be in six. He will be six. He was looking for fifth. And I thought he might have had it, but I believe the caution came out. A lot of fluid down the front straightaway.
From the 45 of Smith, he elected not to race the B main earlier, just for a couple of laps. So I believe the 14 of Kerr, at least for the time of the race,
the lap we were coming in yellow, actually the lap prior to the yellow, as we get the one to go sound, but Ronnie Lee's running in sixth, and he was looking for fifth, and would have had it, and let the caution come out, and actually he just gets a shot at a few more people now, as his Dixie Double File restarts, you're certainly making things interesting.
No doubt about that, and typically when a race starts, you're going to have your fastest laps in the first few laps, and then it starts slowing down as we get toward the end of this 50-lapper, and it'll be interesting to see who's got up the right tires to take it home to victory lane.
Weaver trying to go toward the road in Southern All-Star action. Kerr trying to get the first win of his career in Southern All-Star action. Welcome to Green, down the first straightaway, and once again, there's our restart. Here comes Ronnie Lee. Ronnie Lee's got a chance. Down back straight away. Looks like Weeks, Payne, Ronnie Lee, and Giffen battle for fifth in turn three. Oh, Mike Weeks has front runs. He's going to slow. It's a mass scramble behind him. Down the back side goes the battle for third between David Payne and Ronnie Lee Hollingsworth.
Bobby Giffen there as well. That's a great battle off of turn four. J. Wilson and Lakes, 160 to wheel meantime, about 8 car lengths out on the 14th Kerr.
Wilson and Creel, caution is out, they got together, caution is out for the 22, and Mike Weeks on the backside, he's going to pull up the lane and come to a stop.
Get too much grip sometimes, they can rip the rear ends, they can tear up a lot of things underneath these races, because all the rain that we've had, Travis, that's a cause for a very soppy racetrack earlier, and now it's really hooked up and got some reds working in it. Here we go, green once again.
We're back green, Wolf and Green, down the first straightaway, green, cool, and Hollingsworth going to try to use the top to see what he can do for it. Oh, Payne pushes up the racetrack, he would have had a great run, and that got backfired, and Freddie Smith, look at Freddie Smith, he is up to six, and on the outside, the Southern German comes.
He's trying to find a smooth line around the racetrack, very easy. was a fast match, no doubt about that.
One thing that's a key characteristic about those World Coast race cars is they're able to stay straight, and stay straight when it matters the most. Like on these World Race tracks, you gotta drive it slow, but it comes out fast, so that's the key to these World Coast chassis.
Slow down and get there quicker. No doubt, that's definitely working in the 116 Weaver's favor. Kurt is trying to find a quick line to chase him down. It's not going to happen. There are about 12 car lengths now separating the top two.
He's going in low, he's going in high. He's just trying to find something out of sync. Hollingsworth going to make an attempt in three. He almost had it in two. David Payne works off of four. We'll see what Hollingsworth does in one and two. Hollingsworth lies in on the bottom. Payne, they must be right there at the schoolhouse bell right across. It must be a heck of a lot because it's giving everybody all sorts of problems as they work in one and two.
Oh, just hit it. It almost came to a complete stop there. Barely able to get by with a limped race car.
That time, Hollingsworth was able to get through without any major problems as they're smoke developing out beneath the 201 and Billy Over James now.
Right there coming up on the back bumper of the 201. That's an unusual sight. Now Arnold beginning to smoke even more up in turn 3 and 4, and he is very slow on the racetrack.
And it looks like he may pull up to stop as he slowed down the first straightaway. The leaders have done got by. Will complete a lap. Hollingsworth still chasing the coach. David Payne from the 92. Sideways into the run. Hollingsworth starting to show smoke underneath the bat mount as the yellow flag flies.
Definitely some right front suspension damage, and these cars are built so right, they can't take the damage.
As they can clear the show, out of the 18 car, as man, attrition has really done a number on this car here at the mountain. And Brad, I know you know, I
was very proud of the track last week, but man, what a difference a week makes.
Going back clean here, motion way up the racetrack. Look at Freddie Smith. Freddie Smith trying. He knows he's got to go, and he's got to go down. Freddie goes to the top and three, gets a run. He looks, it looks like it handles pretty decent. Off of four, trying to get by. Bob Gifford was working on it. Only going to the line.
Yeah, there goes.
Ronnie Lee with problems. He's going to exit off the speedway, staying green. That will keep Bobby Gifford for Freddie Smith from 20th to a top five spot.
In the meantime, Kerr is hanging around with the 116th of Peter. He's still going to battle and just past the halfway point.
Kerr told me earlier, you know, every time we come here, it's between me and Lee. He said, it's I win, he finishes second.
Attrition definitely winning the race. Look at the battle off of turn four. Kerr looks to the high side of Weaver.
Oh, he tried. He switched. He thought he was going to hold the pass up there, but Weaver just kind of stepped on it just a little bit more.
Three to go. So, Brady, what are you doing? I'm going to have a look and have five cars finish this thing. That'll do her in.
Time, and now Weaver's on his toes. Weaver knows if he can pull away a little bit, he may have this thing in the bag.
it's all over, because he has been battling that thing with a four-inch steering wheel to boot.
And with the ball and steering wheel, he may hand it back to Kelson and say, yeah, well, I'm sorry, it's got a few bends in it where he's got his hands on that wheel and he's all over the place. And maybe he's catching him. We'll see. We'll check the computer here in a minute. We'll see. And the Toyota Tommy Curry is quicker than Weaver as that traffic about to come in the key.
Needs to slow down, follow that bottom line, ride in Randy Weaver's tire tracks, try to chase him down, and then try to maybe make a couple more stabs at him. Meanwhile, Randy about to catch some of the back markers in turn four.
And he's going to have to go high when he gets through him, and he's going to run to the bottom. Curry's about a half a second a lot quicker than him, as well. Maybe he just found a faster lane and threw the outside. Let's see if he goes back to it in 1-2. He'll be at the bottom, and Roy Curry has his own car on him, like he will.
It just doesn't seem to take the bumps like the other cars. It's smooth even up in the ruts. Lost some ground there, though.
And that time, Weaver was faster than he did. Oh, my lap car. Whoa! He had to roll up and do it quick. As now, Curry's going to come up on the lap car. He's racing for position. He'll go low under Baggerly down the backside.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, climbing out of the car here is your race winner here at the Mountain Raceway Park. He led every lap en route to this victory, and he's exhausted, you know it. Give him a round of applause, the Dream, Randy Weaver. He'll hold this $5,000 check up high, his second $5,000 check in a row on a Southern All-Star Series Tour. Come here, I got you a bottle of water. I know you are exhausted. Yeah. Go ahead and get you a drink of water. I'll give you that as you've earned it. You worked very hard. $5,000 check here. The Big Ace Custom Graphics check here. And Big Ace Custom Graphics Victory Lane. We'll get this trophy on over here. Man, I could just tell you're exhausted. You led every lap. You ever had to work that hard to lead every lap?
No, and I ain't for sure. I need to do that again. I know coffee's and them trying to make it racy, but whatever we done on this deal, check that off the list, because it's hard to race when it's wide open, one thing, but when it's real rough like that, and I know they didn't want it that way, but, last year in this race, it was black and smooth, and Mean Skip had a heck of a race right there at the end. I didn't think it could get any better than that, so I don't know why you'd change it, but got to thank all my crew. They work their tail off every week. This Blomquist race car, I'm telling you, anybody in the grandstands could drove it. It's that good. R.E.D., B.K.W., Bird's Radiator, everybody involved is definitely well appreciated in our group.
All right, well, yeah, I know you had intentions on going up to Eldora. The motor didn't come in time. You fired it up the first time this morning, took a scare in hot laps. Tell us about that. Looks like you just kind of lost power.
Yeah, we was rushing, and, Junior Weisgarber that owns this stuff, and he's down there thrashing early this morning. The rest of us thought we had it all pretty much done, so we kind of eased in late. But in hot laps, it just wouldn't run right. But he's a heck of a mechanic and crew chief, and he got it fixed up for us. We ended up, I called a gear change on it, and it really killed us. I didn't want to run that fast of a pace, but Tommy kind of made me, and my stuff was getting hot. The motor just wasn't running up to par because we had way too much gear in it, and that's why I stayed on the bottom, plus hunting a smooth deal. But besides all that, I appreciate all the fans being here and stuff. I mean, I love doing this, and I wish I could have been at Eldora, but if not, we do the next best thing. You never know. We might try to run for East Points again. But definitely this race and every race I win rest this year is dedicated to my good buddy Calvin Cheek that passed away on us, and never will forget him. And he helped me more than anybody here probably knows.
Well, it's your second Southern All-Star victory in a row. You won last time out at Cleveland. Last year when you won this race, you told me right here, You wasn't decided if you were going to run for points. You went on to run for points and win, and you're getting close up there despite the couple races that you've missed, and you're second in points after the drop. I think you're leading this deal. You guys got to think about that, especially with the year y'all have had.
Yeah, we started out a little slow and getting used to these race cars because they are so different. But Scott talked to me about that the last time I was at his shop, and you know he wants to win, of course, the Lucas points, and he wants us to probably go after the Southern All Stars again. I mean, it just makes his cars look better. But you know, we'll talk about it this week. We're going to try to get ready and go to Cleveland for the Lucas race, and after this, I'm sure we're going to have to rebuild this whole thing. So you know, we'll be busy, but I would have to say probably 95% that we'll probably go ahead and race for the points, but I'm not for sure.
All right, well, I guess we'll say that we'll see you June 26th at Screven. Ladies and gentlemen, it's second Southern All-Star win in a row. Hard-fought victory here. Led all 50 laps. Put your hands together. Your race winner of the dream, Randy Weaver. Right now here, get a quick interview with our second-place man, David Payne. Man, you had a lot of people rooting for you, but man, that deal just kind of, it just got tough out there.
I tell you what, it got there to the point where you're just trying to maintain and not hit those big holes and get a good finish. We had a pretty good race car, but you know, it was just maintained in there towards the end.
At what point did you realize, hey, I'm sitting second, we only have a handful of laps to go, I got something for him? I know you gave it a shot, but he just pulled away.
Well, they came across the receiver and said that me and Randy were the only ones on that lap. And tried to run it hard through 1 and 2 down there and packed the right rear full of mud, and it was pretty much over at that point.
Well, you got to use a loophole in the rules there with the official helping you out because you were the only car on the lead lap or going to the tail of the lead lap. And just talk about that. I mean, knowing in your mind that you're the last car on the lead lap, you're running second, you don't have anything to lose when you go off into turn one.
Well, I had two scenarios. If they hadn't pulled the mud out, then I was just going to ride around, let them pass me, and not worry about losing those positions. Or if they pulled it out, maybe I could get through there and he might have pushed or broke or something. I tell you what, first time out with this race car, Masters built, Keith and Taylor Masters, Ray Cook, Gibson Motorsports, and GW Performance. These guys have just got us a real good piece here.
All right, well, good job. Hard fought second place.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, David Payne, your second place finisher.